Hello, dear Scorpios. Welcome to your reading for June. And what I have in store for you this month is really beautiful. My Lilith is in Scorpio, and that's the black moon, the dark moon. And I always thought that people who were Scorpios were unpredictable, and I thought they were a little bit scary. And surprise! I'm maybe a little bit scary to others sometimes. What is the message for you in June? You have a lot of blessings, but you have to surrender something. And you can surrender it to your angel Raziel. Raziel is the angel of the karma card, who knows everything. He knows all what is hidden. And he's also written a book about it. It's the myth, of course, it's a metaphor. He knows everything and he wants to guide you. He wants to guide you through all these emotions, of this sea of emotions who is hidden in you. This is the first week, the second, the third, and the fourth week. The first week in June, you have the moon. What is hidden for yourself? Is it true? What you're feeling? Or are you becoming a little bit paranoid? Sometimes Scorpios will see everything very clearly, but sometimes they over-exaggerate and they are lost. Are they feelings of their own, or are the feelings of somebody else? And sometimes it's good just to let it go and be honest and be forward. What are your own intention? What are your own plans? And then you have an emotional rest. And the second week, if you surrender to Raziel, if you surrender to the universe, if you surrender to the universe and know that it's a safe place for you and that everything will work out fine, then there is the star blessing for you, the beautiful naked woman in the sea of emotions. There is healing, and look, she is in her element, and you are in your element, but you have to surrender, and then you can receive the blessings. And look at the third week, the Ace of Pentacles. So the money is coming, the work is coming, your house is okay, your family is okay, everything of the earthly realm is there for you. But you have to take a step back, because I know you are the magician of your own world, and there are many Scorpios like me who are psychic, or they can see or feel things before they happen. But now you have to let it come to you. Let life surprise you. I think that's the message. And then you get all the blessings. And this is the Strength card for week four. You have to balance out your emotions. Are you angry? Are you Zen? Do you meditate? Do you take full responsibility for everything you are and everything you feel? And are you willing to sit still in the middle? That's the Buddhist way. Not in a polarity of things, but in the middle. See things as they are. Come as you are. Don't try to outsmart people with your knowledge and your wisdom and your insights. Just let everybody come to you in their own way, with their own challenges, with their own feelings. And maybe they will come easier to you. Because sometimes, yes, you can be a little bit scary. You see right through people, and that gives them a sense of that they are naked. in front of you. So a simple prayer can be, Raziel, you can close your eyes, Raziel, please guide me with all your wisdom and all your knowledge and all your foresight to the place where I can receive my blessings. And I thank you for these blessings. I'm willing and able to receive everything the universe has in store for me. And I will let my ego rest and take all your love as a blessing. And so it is, and so it is, and so it is. So, dear Scorpios, I hope you have a wonderful month in June. I would really like you to subscribe to my channel. Then you will be the first to see my uploads if you hit the notification bell. Sometimes I give a meditation with the full moon or the new moon. And I know it can be a challenge. My Lilith is in Scorpio. So I know it's a lot, but just relax and receive all your blessings. I hope to see you in July. Bye.